you ever been overwhelmed by beat sheets or really complicated outline templates? In this video, I give you a really simple way to outline your story or novel, thinking about it in three different sections. So if that sounds like something you're interested in, this video is for you. Professional writer and project coordinator, and I love helping frustrated writers organize their writing process so that they can finish their projects and meet their goals. Without further ado, let's talk about outlining. The thing that's tricky about outline templates is that they don't always fit every story. If you're using a template that has a breakdown of 15 different scenes and what those scenes should be about, it may not be the right fit for your story because your story might need to take a different turn or flow in a different way. But the outlining method I'm going to show you breaks down the process into only three parts that will hopefully be a little bit more flexible and allow you to apply it to every story or novel that you're working on. So whenever you outline, you want to do a few drafts. James Patterson is really well known for his outlines, saying that he does at least 3 to 6 drafts before he starts writing. My suggestion is to start with the big picture points and then get more specific and more detailed with each draft of your outline. So what do you need before you outline? You need a premise and you need characters. A premise gives your story direction and focus and lets you know what your main character is going to learn by the end. Knowing your characters and how they either agree or disagree with the premise will help you determine what kinds of conflict they can get into throughout your story. I won't go into detail about how to figure out your premise or develop your characters here, but if you want more information on how to do that, I've made videos on both topics that you can check out. So once you have your premise and you've developed your characters, you can break your outline into 3 sections. The first section to think about is the turning point. The second is where you build tension leading up to your turning point. And the third section is where the lesson is learned, your character is moving away from what they previously believed and moving closer to accepting the premise. So for this video, let's use the example that our premise is true friendship can get you through any hardship. So that's what our main character has to learn by the end of the story. And we'll say our main character is a kid in his early teens whose background and history has made him pretty distrusting of people, and he's kind of a loner. Maybe he's facing difficulties at home or with his family that are making him more and more depressed, and maybe he gets involved in some shady hobbies. So if I were really taking on this story, I would dive much deeper into the who, what, and why of this character. Why is he this way? What difficulties is he facing? Who else is in his life? And how do they view the premise? But for now, we know he totally disagrees with the premise that true friendship can help you through any hardship, and that's what he's going to end up learning by the end of the story. So, what I suggest is always starting with your turning point. This could also be called a midpoint, though I don't really think it has to come right at the middle of your story, but it should come around the halfway to two-thirds point of your story. So the turning point is the point where your character stops fighting the premise and starts considering that it might be true. So they start the book thinking, absolutely not. Friendship does not help you at all. It doesn't help you get through anything. Friendship sucks. But once they've hit the turning point, they start leaning just a little bit closer to the premise, and they're thinking, maybe there is something to this whole friendship thing. So what could that be for our main character? The first thing that comes to mind to me is that he's going to meet somebody who he's going to have a really strong friendship with, someone that changes his mind. So I'll use that as my turning point in the first draft of my outline. MC, main character, meets someone he'll connect with. From there, you can start to fill out the other two sections of your outline. In the events leading up to the turning point, I try to think about what might chip away from what the character thinks he knows. So what events will tell the reader more about who he is and what he believes, and break down his view of the premise leading up to the turning point. So let's say a few of the events should be centered around our character's life at home or at school. We want to show what his life is like, what his family dynamic is like, and how he distrusts others. Maybe we see him in class refusing to participate or being rude when someone in class is trying to be nice to him. We could see him at home. Maybe his parents invite their family friends over and their family friends have a kid about his age and we see them interacting. Or maybe he has that shady hobby and we get to see him participate in that. So those kinds of events can give us a sense of who our character is and what he believes. Then we want to think about those events that are going to chip away at what he believes. Remember, we're trying to build up towards the turning point. So maybe a new kid comes into one of his classes and something about the way he or she talks or carries himself gets our main character to notice them. He's kind of intrigued by them, but he shuts it down because he's not in a trusting place yet. Even though he shuts it down, it's still an event that undermines what he believes about the premise because he's seeing this person and thinking, could they be a friend? Even if he doesn't admit that to himself. So let's see how our outline is looking so far. So we see we have our main character in class refusing to participate, interacting with a family friend's kid so that we can see how he interacts with others. He takes part in his sketchy hobby. He notices something different about a new kid, and then you can keep building on that. So he notices something else, but he denies his interest. He's like, whatever, it doesn't matter. Then he notices something else that piques his interest, and he's like, maybe this person is different. And then that leads up to the turning point. But see how each of these points is big picture? We don't know the details yet, but we have a sense of how the story might unfold. In the final section of your outline, I like to think about what is going to take my character from considering the premise might be true to believing the premise is true. The character has to reach some kind of crisis point where they discover that the premise is worth believing in. So for our character, maybe his shady hobby gets him into some serious trouble and he can't get out of it on his own. His friend, the new kid, helps him get through it, and that's what ultimately solidifies the premise for our main character. So that's kind of the moment of crisis, but this kid is pretty distrusting, so I think other events in this third section could be around our main character testing his friendship with the new kid, trying to determine whether or not this new kid is actually a true friend or is just going to be like everyone else. So maybe that translates into an event where our main character tests his new friend to see if he's really loyal. So maybe he picks an argument with him, maybe his friend starts inviting him to things, and maybe through forming a friendship with this new kid, our main character is eventually able to open up and really share more about himself and what he's experienced. By the end, our main character should be in a place where they're accepting the premise that true friendship can get you through any hardship. So from our turning point where the main character has met the new kid, someone he'll connect with, the new kid invites our main character to do something with them, our main character picks a fight to test their friendship, but the new kid proves friendship with our main character by not abandoning them, by working through it, then we can hit our crisis point. Our main character is in real trouble and the new kid has to help him out. That leads the main character to realize that this friendship is actually something he can trust, so he opens up to his friend and realizes the true value of their friendship. And from there, our main character can accept the premise and is changed. Now, we also know that as this friendship is developing, our main character is still involved in that shady hobby, and it's getting him into more and more trouble. So we need to include that in our outline as well. Let's see what our outline might look like if we take that into account. So you see, as the friendship is developing, we have these subplots happening beneath. Main character makes a choice about their shady hobby. That choice leads them to having to make another choice, and that choice eventually leads them to the trouble that they're going to need rescuing from. So now that we have all of those big picture plot points in mind, the first draft of our outline is basically done. You can add more events, take some away, reorganize them, shuffle them up, whatever works for you. But from there, you can go into your second draft, which will have a lot more detail. And I find the best way to work on a second draft outline is to ask yourself a lot of questions about each point. So let's look at our first event. MC is in class and refuses to participate. So the questions I might ask, what class is it? How is he being asked to participate? Why is he refusing? Has something happened at home and put him in a bad mood? Does he not like this teacher? Does he hate this class? And then how do the other characters respond? His teacher, his classmates? Answering questions like those can really help you flesh out a scene and see how it plays out in your mind. You can then add those details to the next draft of your outline. Alright, so to recap, before you outline, don't forget to figure out your premise and develop your characters. Then, for the first draft of your outline, start with the big picture points. First, determine your turning point, the event at which your main character is going to start considering that the premise might be true. Then, think about which points are going to build tension up to the turning point. Show who your character is and why they reject the premise. Finally, think about what points might follow the turning point. What will solidify the premise in your character's mind and leave them changed? So I hope that this method gives you a little bit of flexibility to determine plot points for your story, no matter what kind of story you're writing. If you want more tips on how to organize your writing, hit the like and subscribe buttons, and I'll see you in my next video.